It occurred yesterday. SpaceX installed the most powerful rocket booster ever assembled, on the launch mount with giant robot arms. This is not the first such trip, for the Starship's Super Heavy first stage in general, nor for this specific booster, which we have now come to fondly refer to as Booster 7 or B7. I know I shouldn't say it because it might be a jinx, but I hope this is the last time before it launches. SpaceX has begun lifting the approximately 70-meter-tall rocket onto the launch mount, using two massive arms attached to the pad's launch tower. The entire procedure was completed in less than half an hour, which is quite impressive. While Musk claims that the ultimate goal is to use those arms to catch starships and other heavy objects in midair, their current purpose is to replace a tall and unwieldy crane that would otherwise be required to lift either stage. The arms are a complex solution, but they allow SpaceX to remotely lift, install, and remove Starship stages, as well as insulate those processes from wind conditions that cranes are sensitive to. Once the booster is fully secured by the mount's 20 hold-down clamps, it will be connected to ground systems, allowing SpaceX to prepare B7 for the next stage of pre-flight testing, as early as today. SpaceX is completely confident that Booster 7 will be mated with its companion Ship 24 as early as April. Speaking of Ship 24, its flight termination system box has been prepared for launch. When all is said and done, the combined massive launch system stands nearly 400 feet tall, at around 390 feet to be precise, and is supported by an orbital launch stand. The entire structure stands about 475 feet tall, which is taller than the Great Pyramid of Giza. As for when the orbital launch test will actually take place, it is not yet clear because final preparations will take some time, but the company is still aiming to do so in April. Of course, receiving a launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration is on the list of things SpaceX needs to do to get Starship flight ready. This won't happen until the regulator has completed an environmental assessment, which could take weeks. It should come as no surprise that SpaceX will test this strange naked Starship prototype, even before the Starship's orbital flight. Because Ship 26 was also lifted and moved to the production site for engine installation, where it received the RVC-205, and then yesterday the 212. We haven't seen a RVAC in a while, but when we do, it's always exceptional, right? In the Mega Bay, a new ship was being stacked in the High Bay, but not in the way we've seen before. From Ship 24 to Ship 27, ships were being stacked first in two main sections, with the top of the ship made up of the nose cone, the payload bay, and then the forward dome section of the ship. The bottom of the ship would be composed of the common dome section, the middle of the liquid oxygen tank, or the mid-lock section for short, and the aft dome section. Each of these halves would be stacked separately, and then joined together in the high bay to form the entire ship. However, for Ship 28, this is not the case. Instead, the top section of the ship is now stacked on the common dome section, implying that stacking has occurred from the top down, with no more two halves being assembled. If you got lost in all of this, we do have a video that we made that was a complete explanation of how Ship 24 and Booster 7 are assembled. Nonetheless, nothing matter how SpaceX ready to launch their Starship, until FAA approve launch license. But on Wednesday, SpaceX's Vice President Tom Occhialuro also announced that the Starship orbital launch is so close that we're still waiting on our FAA license, so that we can announce our launch date, but with testing mostly behind SpaceX. That license to launch may now be the biggest source of uncertainty for the Starship's orbital class debut. If SpaceX wants to avoid additional review and eventually receive an FAA license, it must guarantee that it will complete more than 75 changes to its proposal for the Starbase facility. This is primarily due to SpaceX's Starbase facility being located in a small town called Boca Chica, Texas, right on the southern tip of Texas, to launch its new Starship rocket to orbit from the site. For the last few years, SpaceX has used the site along the Rio Grande River and the U.S.-Mexico border to build full-scale prototypes of Starship. The company's next-generation monster rocket, designed to transport people and cargo to deep space destinations, such as the Moon and Mars. SpaceX has already conducted several high-altitude test flights with Starship prototypes from Starbase. But the company now hopes to launch Starship into orbit for the first time. SpaceX requires a launch license from the FAA, before launching Starship into orbit from Starbase, and the fate of SpaceX's Boca Chica facility has been in doubt for nearly 2 years. While the FAA conducts an environmental review of how the company's launch operations will impact the surrounding area. Initially, SpaceX had no plans to launch its future Moon and Mars rocket from Texas. Indeed, the company's first piece of land in Boca Chica, purchased in 2012, was intended to be a commercial launch site for its smaller Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, with the goal of launching up to 12 times per year from this serene location. The FAA completed a thorough environmental study of the proposed launch site in 2014. To make sure that SpaceX's plans complied with environmental rules, and were away from the hustle and bustle of its much busier launch facilities in Cape Canaveral, Florida. Despite the original plan, the agency published an environmental impact statement that detailed how the smaller launches would affect the area. SpaceX eventually decided to launch its future Moon and Mars rockets from Boca Chica. After realizing that the site's remote location and proximity to the Gulf of Mexico made it an ideal location for testing and launching Starship spacecraft, which can take many months, if not years, to complete. As it necessitates interviews with experts, scientists, business officials, and residents, as well as rigorous analysis and research into how a proposed action will affect the nearby human environment. However, SpaceX's plans have shifted significantly since the original was published. Beginning in 2018, the company significantly increased production activities in Boca Chica, after deciding to devote the South Texas facility solely to the production of Starship prototypes. The more modest commercial launch facility that SpaceX once envisioned has evolved into a thriving installation, filled with massive warehouses, intense construction, and thousands of employees working around the clock. As SpaceX's presence in the area grew, the company began conducting high-altitude flight tests with its Starship prototypes, launching the vehicles up to heights of 30 to 40,000 feet, before attempting to land them back on Earth. The majority of these tests ended in fiery explosions, with only one successfully sticking its tongue out. One prototype blew up just before it was supposed to land in March of 2021. The test flights, combined with ongoing construction and ground testing, have led to growing tensions with the nearby community. The Starbase is located next to a small neighborhood of a couple dozen homes called Boca Chica Village, which is only really accessible via one lone state highway that connects the Starbase. During tests and other demonstrations, that road is frequently closed, limiting access to both the village and the nearby area. Beach residents also complained about disruptions to their daily lives, as they were frequently asked to leave their homes during major tests. Many Boca Chica Village residents have sold their properties to SpaceX. Despite the fact that some residents have remained in their homes, the FAA announced in late 2020 that it would conduct an environmental review of SpaceX's plans to launch Starship into orbit from Starbase.